I am too old, sire. Then you, Brother Paul.
The honor should fall upon you, sire.
Again.
Forget your rank, Captain. Forget mine.
That's all no, Prince. I've a good mind to take you over my knee and give you the whipping you deserve.
Too old and too late.
By all the saints, sire, you drove me to it.
I can have you flogged for that.
So please, Your Highness. I promised your father when he died that I would protect you from that Satan in skirt who holds his crown.
Call the broken jaw protection.
You should have taken me with you. Suppose you've been challenged or called to the chapel. I want a Father Joseph. Did you consider the risk to him? He's a dangerous time, sire. Not all those woodsmen are well disposed toward you.
You fuss like an old woman. We're in no danger. Chapel is complete. We raise the cross today.
And Father Joseph?
Frail in body, but not in spirit.
Oh, if only your dear mother and father were alive to see this day.
How
proud they would have been of you.
And like your stepmother, who by the by has already sent an envoy in search of you,
have you forgot this day?
You should have been here to reach your future wife. No. No, I have not forgotten. And please, don't tell me what a beauty she is. Or how obedient and submissive. I shall only be civil because the rules of chivalry decree that I should greet her as an honored visitor.
She seems as gentle as a monk.
You know as well as I that this marriage is a mockery. I will not be used by my stepmother in her greedy games.
But your child knows not of that.
No. God protect her. When did they arrive?
An hour ago, and the queen is soon to give them audience, and you should be there. Good manners, if nothing else.
Oh, go, my dear.
If only to please an old lady.
Very well. Here's you.
There must be more willing girls for you to take as a wife.
You will only as plain and vulgar as her father. I can dismiss her without regret. But there's a manner about her, Tomas.
Bad temper.
She seems to me altogether remarkable.
I'd rather face a wild boar. Who's there? Show yourself!
Such eyes.
A man could drown in those eyes.
And did you see the way she defied the queen?
Then oblige the queen, sire, and marry her.
And sacrifice the poor girl for the sake of her own dowry? I think not, Tomas. Besides, the wench has made her feelings plain enough.
Come. Madam, Prince Wenceslas. Must you always enter the room as if you were on horseback?
You sent for me, stepmother.
Where have you been since midday?
Do I smell priest? Or is it horse flesh? So difficult to tell the two apart, don't you think?
Where have you been? You think that silence is the proper response?
Does a king have to answer to such a demand?
King, is it?
Just when did you complete your apprenticeship for this position?
While the regency is still mine, you will do as I bid.
Just practicing.
Oh, do try to be punctual on the day of your wedding. It's one of those strange little rituals of courtship that requires your presence.
Unless, of course, you've taken a vow of virginity. One day your sour tongue will trick you up, stepmother.
Monster!
Good night. Wenceslas, my lady. He has a little bit of a temper, my lady.
One of our horses fell dead on the journey here. The cold, I suppose, kept the wolves happy after that. You were close enough to keep the blood on your cheek. That bell, why does it ring so?
Calls the sheep for fleecing. Today the peasants pay their monthly dues to the tax collector.
But I know you. You're the trumpeter from the gallery.
My brother. We look much alike. I'm just a humble groom, my lady.
Well, if you're the prince's groom, you must know him well. What was the matter with him? Well, you can tell me it'll go no further, I swear. Is he well favored?
Oh, not at all. This horse is prettier.
Why do you stare, sir? You are impertinent.
Between ourselves, my lady, the prince is no match for one as fine as you. Between ourselves, my lady, the prince is no match for one as fine as you. You have eyes that can melt the coldest heart.
And now you mock me?
No. No, not I.
Eyes that could melt the coldest heart. That's from some verse, I'm sure of it. I believe you were told to say these things to me by your master.
Not the prince, my lady. He's very coarse in his ways.
They told me he could read Latin.
Oh, he can't read. He's cross-eyed. Release the woodsman.
Your Highness.
Enough, my Lord Chamberlain.
This is more than enough, sir.
Then let the man go.
I told you, one more cell, the ball.
Hey.
Sir!
Take this man to the kitchen. See that he has food to take home. Go to the kitchen with my page. We will give you food for your child.
You were right, sire. The horse is prettier.
He spoke only once, and briefly. As he raised his sword, he shouted, "This is done in the name of Wenceslas." That evil monster Garmin will pay for this with his life.
That is in the hands of God, my dear.
Madam, what further sign do you need of the Queen's treachery?
Captain is right, ma'am. The Queen wishes us nothing but ill will. It is no longer safe for even you to carry a book of prayers. And there is more. In the city, I heard rumors of a new coin to be minted. My stepmother's regency ends in the spring when I come of age. The coin is to celebrate my coronation. No, sire, not this one. It seems that the royal treasury has been ordered by the Queen to engrave all new coins of the realm with your stepmother's likeness.
Oh, if that woman is allowed to rule, there will be no peace in Bohemia. Since your father died, I have counseled you to put away the sword and pray for spiritual guidance, believing that the shedding of blood can only cause a greater rift between good Christian men and those that side with the Queen. But now it is clear. You can no longer wait until you are king.
Thomas, write to Budetsch and show this ring to Baron Yezhi. To no one else. From your hand to his.
Shall be done.
Lord Yezhi will understand what it signifies.
A call to arms, sire?
If the Queen believes I am powerless to act until I come of age, she has a surprise awaiting her. There is nothing to fear. It's cold as a grave in here. Why is there no fire?
Master, we have no logs to burn.
Woman, you are surrounded by trees. Why do you not help yourself to fuel? Without fire, you will perish.
The Lord says we are forbidden to take even one twig of the royal forest.
What law? I know of your such decree.
By order of Prince Wenceslas, Master.
Devil are you?
On whose orders do you forbid these people to take game or firewood?
On the orders of Prince Wenceslas.
Troublemaker!
Your Majesty has no horses to tend to?
I need your counsel, Johanna.
Sire, you may do with me as you wish. Mock me if it amuses you. Marry me if you must. My father signed a contract. What choice do I have?
I have never taken anything by force or guile, certainly not a bride.
And I have no desire to be in a marriage.
It is about the marriage contract that I wish to talk to you.
To be married to the future king will reflect much honor on the bride's father.
But you and I are of one mind, I think. That there should be no wedding.
Why, sire, your hand is bleeding. This must be bathed in red.
We must endure the betrothal feast together. But you have nothing to fear from my stepmother while I am by your side. She is not all she seems, you know. Her true nature is sly and scheming.
And then she is exactly what she seems. When I told her I wished to go home, she looked at me as if she'd had me thrown to the wolves.
Fortunate wolves.
Do you not drink, my lady?
Thank you, but I prefer water.
Perhaps my lady fears some vile potion in her goblet.
There's but one way to know that.
No, sire. Me be the taster.
Who was it said chivalry belonged to a bygone age?
If his royal highness wishes me dead, he has only to marry me himself. One night with you, sire, I would achieve more than a barrel of poison.
Johanna.
Well said.
Your daughter has a sharp tongue, my lord.
Madam, I cannot imagine bearing a greater shame than this.
Oh, please, now, do not distress yourself. Better a cat than a milksop kitten.
Where is my grandmother?
Unwell, perhaps.
She was perfectly well at noon.
This is indeed a time for celebration, since from the happy union of these two people, your daughter and my stepson, will spring an alliance stretching from the far mountains of Bohemia to the lush farmlands of your duchy. Thus united, our two royal houses will stand rich and invincible. However, even such joy as this must be tinged with sorrow. For the widowed Queen Ludmilla has told me of her desire to withdraw from court and seek solace for her final days in solitary contemplation, far away from us all.
She shall not be exiled.
Sit down.
This banishment is your doing.
I command you to be seated. You will not leave.
Grandmother, no harm.
If I allow you to pass, sire, the guard commander will have me whipped.
And if you don't, I shall have you whipped.
Sire, what am I to do? My instructions are to let no one pass in either direction. I'm a good soldier, and know only that I must obey orders.
Then I order you to stand aside.
Now I have two orders to obey. You see the position I'm in.
Now I see the position you're in.
I'm always happy to be of service to His Majesty. Well, ask anything of me, sir. I shall want no extra pay. I'm good with horses. I was born in a stable.
I don't know if you have spirit.
Not to let her go.
I will not. Grandmother.
Oh, Wenceslas.
This banishment must be opposed by force if necessary.
Oh, my dear. You were but a child when your father died. You have no knowledge of the battle I have had in your upbringing. I only wanted to form your heart to the love of God as your father would have wished. That woman did everything in her power to thwart me.
Does she really believe she control me by separating us?
It is my influence over you that she fears. Oh, my continued presence here can only be a danger to you and to me.
You have always been by my side, Grandmother.
If you obstruct her in this, she will simply find some other way to dispose of me. Oh, no. I am too old to fight.
I shall never submit to her will.
Your Majesty, every valley and pass between here and Tetim will be blocked with snow. It is a terrible journey.
You will be my guide and comfort. Be wise, my dear. It is only a brief separation before your coronation.
Then Tomas and his men must travel with you.
Oh, no, no. The court has never been more divided in its loyalties. You are in constant danger. Tomas must remain here with you at all times. No, do not worry. We shall come to no harm. God is with us.
This is all due to your ignorance, you foolish child. It seems that Her Majesty has finally lost patience. But take no notice of my daughter, sire. She may appear reluctant to assume the responsibilities of marriage, but she will grow to appreciate the arrangement.
Don't talk to me, Father, as if I were deaf and dumb. I understand my position very well and can speak for myself.
My Lord Duke, why do you think the Queen has encouraged this betrothal?
A marriage made in heaven, sire. Or the next best thing.
No. For one reason only. Greed. For the golds you brought with you in the border territory. Once the Queen has those, your daughter's presence in this castle will be as fleeting as a snowflake on a summer's day. She will not live long enough to bear me a son.
Then you misjudge me, sire. And so does she.
Indeed, you do misjudge her. She's as strong as a horse and as stubborn as a mule.
If this marriage takes place now, the Queen will see to it that nothing comes between Prince Boleslav and the crown he covets. My only wish is to protect Johanna.
I do not fear the Queen at all.
I must be sicker than I thought. First she says, no, I hate him. He has the manners of a pig. Then she says, never. I would rather die than be wed. Now she takes up her wifely duties before the marriage. Confirm it, I will not be treated like a court jester.
God willing, my lord, if you will only do as I ask now, nothing will prevent my marriage to your daughter when I am king. Do I have your allegiance?
Father, please.
There is the possibility, of course, that the Queen might have your throat cut, too.
You have my allegiance.
You must be ready to leave within the hour. My grandmother goes with you as far as Tetton.
Made my decision. I need you all, woodsmen, farmers, millers, to come with me back to the castle.
All those not in chains, he means.
The half starved to death.
Not 4 leagues from here, my friend Lord Yeji waits with an armed force to protect you. If it's justice you seek, then help us fight for it.
We pay more taxes because of you. We endure public flogging. Our children starve.
All this is a sickness the Queen has spread. A plague of lies.
Then who were the taxes paid for if not for you?
For the Queen and her henchmen. I say we go. I'm Yen Tere. You all know me.
We are not soldiers, Yantarek. We have no arms, no horses.
We have axes and staves.
You have your fists and your feet.
With right on your side, you will be as knights of God. What say you, friends? Will you march with your future king?
Yes!
You hound of hell! You've sealed your fate now, Prince.
Memory of my father and his love for you, I would have no hesitation killing you both. You, the cause of all this evil, are banished from the realm with your son. Your king. I shall endeavor to rule with mercy. I shall support God's law and his church. I shall be truthful in speech, just in judgment, faithful in everything entrusted to me. The naked shall be clothed and the hungry fed. Our prison shall be destroyed, all gallows cut down.
That's right, sire. We need firewood.
Amongst those who were too frail to join us here today. From now on, no landowner in this castle shall fare better than the man who tills his field. Come, bring it all.
Pack it well, Peter.
God bless you, my lady. Beaver keep the cold at bay.
Thank you, my lady.
You have a spirited daughter, my lord.
She will make the prince a poor wife, I fear. He can't cook, and her sewing is terrible.
I'm sure the girl has other talent. Can she sing?
She has the voice of a frog.
Then, Excellency, their duets will be the talk of all Bohemia.
Jean.
Stolen their hearts as well as mine.
How did they punish the thief in Bohemia?
Drama!
Come with us now, Johanna.
Let me follow where you lead, sire.
I want you always by my side.